We will start. Now we will continue with unit number 1, spur gears. In the last lecture we have seen all these things. Definition of gear drive, classification of gears based on the peripheral velocity, based on type of machine and position of shaft axis. So these were all the gears which we have studied in the classification. Then we have gone through the nomenclature of gear tooth. We have seen some basic equations which we will use for all types of gears. And we have studied the important law of gearing. This is used to design the gear tip profiles, so that the gears in mesh can transmit constant angular velocity ratio. And law of gearing states that common normal at the point of contact of two mating teeth must pass through the pitch point. Next, we have seen the two standard forms of tooth profile which are used in practice. Those are cycloidal and involute gear tooth profiles. These profiles satisfy the law of gearing, so they are called as conjugate tips or conjugate profiles. Now in today's lecture we are going to discuss involute gear tooth action. Henceforth the study of spur gear drive is only for involute profiles. We will not study cycloidal tips because they are not used in practice. Okay. So let us start. Draw one circle like this at the center of your page. Take a rounder pencil and draw a circle with the center line. Next, what is this? This is the pitch circle of gear 1. Ye kya hai? Pitch circle of gear 1. Next, draw the pitch circle of gear 2 in contact with the pitch circle of gear 1. So these are the pitch circles of two mating gears. And pitch circles of two mating gears meet each other at pitch point. So next, mark the centers of both the gears and join the centers using a center line AB. Center of gear 1 is A and center of gear 2 is B. The next, mark the pitch point P. Pitch point is the point of contact of two pitch circles of mating gears, and pitch point lies on the center line. Always, it always lies on the center line. Next, what we have shown, two gears in mesh with each other and pitch circles meet at pitch point P and AB is the center line. Okay, so name the pitch circles. Keep some space between this label and the pitch circle. So, this space ठेवायचे आहे because we are increasing the diagram now. Diagram will go on expanding because we are adding some more features to this diagram. So, now थोडे separate द्यायचे आहेत. Okay, next. Pitch point P. चलो now द्यायची गरज नाही. Now draw the another circle concentric to pitch circle 1. This is base circle of gear 1. Next, draw a circle concentric to pitch circle of gear 2. This circle is base circle of gear 2. बेस सर्कल म्हणजे काय? We generate involute profile above the base circle by rolling a straight line on the circumference of base circle. Involute profiles are generated. म्हणजे ज्या सर्कलवरती आपण स्ट्रेट लाईन रोल करतो, एनी पॉईंट ऑन दॅट लाईन जनरेट्स इन्व्हॉल्यूट कर्व, त्या सर्कलला म्हणायचं बेस सर्कल ऑन विच वी आर रोलिंग द स्टिक ऑर स्ट्रेट लाईन. ओके, सो वी हॅव टू पिच सर्कल्स मीटिंग ॲट पिच पॉईंट पी विच लाईज ऑन सेंटर लाईन ए बी. वी हॅव ड्रॉन द बेस सर्कल्स फॉर बोथ द गिअर्स. नाउ नेक्स्ट, ड्रॉ common tangent to both the base circles. Draw a line which is tangent to both the base circles, and the line must pass through the pitch point P. Draw this line tangent to two base circles and passing through pitch point P. Okay, common tangent to two base circles and passing through pitch point P. And all of you will remember that base circle is not the root circle. Okay, root circle is different than the base circle. We have drawn base circle, not root circle. Okay, line tangent to two base circles passing through pitch point P. Okay, now next. If this line is tangent to base circle 1, it will be perpendicular to radius of rotation at the point of contact E. Okay. So draw this line AE on gear 1. Line joining center of gear 1 and the point of contact of common tangent with the base circle. Draw the line AE. This line AE is perpendicular to the common tangent. Similarly, draw line BF for gear 2. So this is joining the center to the point of contact of common tangent. So line BF is also perpendicular to the common tangent EF. Okay. तेजस कुलकर्णी काढले का? मिस करायचं नाही, ती डायग्राम वाढत जाणार आहे. ओके, नेक्स्ट हे काय लिहू नका बाकी, जस्ट ड्रॉ द डायग्राम अँड ट्राय टू अंडरस्टँड. व्हॉट इज एफ ई? एफ ई इज कॉमन टँजेंट टू टू बेस सर्कल्स, बेस सर्कल ऑफ गिअर 1 अँड बेस सर्कल ऑफ गिअर 2 which are shown in blue color. FE, which is common tangent to two base circles, is also normal to AE and BF. This AE and this BF. Okay, this is normal to AE and BF. FE also passes through pitch point P. So we have three properties of this common tangent FE. Common tangent FE is tangent to two base circles. It is normal to the line joining point of contact to the center of gear, and it always passes through the pitch point. The next, green color madhe disse. This is the profile of teeth on gear 1. So draw this. Kutlahi shape kadaycha ek. ग्रीन कलर मध्ये काढलेला आहे. अँड दिस प्रोफाईल शुड स्टार्ट फ्रॉम द बेस सर्कल ओनली. ओके, बिकॉज वी जनरेट द इन्व्हॉल्यूट प्रोफाइल्स बाय रोलिंग स्ट्रेट लाईन ऑन द सर्कमफरन्स ऑफ बेस सर्कल. सो ड्रॉ सम आर्बिट्री शेप फ्रॉम द बेस सर्कल ऑफ गिअर 1. Now draw the profile of teeth on gear 2, which is in mesh with profile on gear 1, and both these profiles will meet each other at point C, and point C lies on the common tangent FE. So draw the two profiles, and both the profiles should meet each other at point C, and point C lies on the common tangent FE. Okay, I will show you once again. This is profile 1. Sorry. Okay, profile of teeth on gear 1, and this is profile on teeth of gear 2. Both these profiles meet each other at point C, and point C lies on common tangent FE. Okay. Now what we have done, two teeth are in contact with each other at point C. Point C always lie on line AE. Okay, you will remember this. In case of involute gears, point of contact between a pair of teeth always lie on common tangent FE. Okay, now next. आता ही डायग्राम कंप्लीट झाल्यानंतर वी विल गो बॅक टू द प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ इन्व्हॉल्यूट कर्व. इन्व्हॉल्यूट कसा जनरेट करतो आपण? दिस इज द सर्कल, आय हॅव शोन दिस इन लास्ट लेक्चर. सपोज आय हॅव याच्यावरती दोरा गुंडाळलेला आहे असं कन्सिडर, अँड देन वी विल अनवाउंड दॅट स्ट्रिंग. ओके, कीपिंग इट टॉट लाईक दिस, असा अनवाउंड केला की दिस इज द इन्व्हॉल्यूट कर्व. हु इज दिस? अक्षय विधाते. वेळेवर यायचं जरा. ओके, आपण काय केलं, हा दोरा या सर्क्युलर सिलेंडरवरनं अनवाउंड केला, कीपिंग इट स्ट्रेट. सो एनी पॉईंट ऑन दिस स्ट्रिंग विल ट्रेस द इन्व्हॉल्यूट कर्व. ओके, मग आपण या रेड सर्कलला काय म्हणतो? बेस सर्कल. वी हॅव शोन द बेस सर्कल ऑफ बोथ द गिअर्स इन ब्ल्यू कलर. ओके, हा तो सर्कल आहे, बेस सर्कल. अँड वॉट वी हॅव सीन, वॉट इज द प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ इन्व्हॉल्यूट? प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ इन्व्हॉल्यूट काय आहे? The line, ही जी लाईन आहे विच इज जनरेटिंग दिस इन्व्हॉल्यूट कर्व इज ऑलवेज नॉर्मल टू द इन्व्हॉल्यूट ऍट ऑल द इन्स्टन्सेस. दिस लाईन इज ऑलवेज नॉर्मल टू द इन्व्हॉल्यूट. नाउ दिस प्रोफाइल्स ऑफ टीथ्स आर इन्व्हॉल्यूट. यांनी काय म्हटलं, लाईन एफ सी इज नॉर्मल टू द इन्व्हॉल्यूट टू ऍट पॉइंट सी. सो दिस लाईन एफ सी which is rolling on this base circle is generating involute of gear 2. So FC is normal to this involute at point C. Correct. Similarly, the line CE which is rolling on base circle 1 is normal to this involute of teeth 1 at point C. Correct. The lines which are generating the involutes are always normal to the involute. Got it? Now, same thing. The line FC is normal to the involute 2 at point C. Line EC normal to involute 1 at point C. This is the property of involute curve which I have just explained. Now draw a line tangent to both these involutes at point C and name it as TT. Okay? Draw a line tangent to both these involutes at point C. draw a line tangent to both these involute curves at point C and name that line as TT. Now, again, FC is normal to the involute at point C, EC is also normal to the involute at point C. That means both these lines are normal to the common tangent TT. Line FC and line EC are normal to the common tangent TT. What does this mean? याचा अर्थ काय होतो? Points F, C and E lie on a single straight line. Because FC and CE are common normal at the point of contact C. So this is the final conclusion. What FCE is a common normal at the point of contact, and that common normal also passes through the pitch point P. Moreover, he ji line ahe FCE, this is also passing through the pitch point P. Moreover, this is also passing through the pitch point P. And what you will remember, he kai lai chan hai, just listen. फक्त डायग्राम काढायचे आहे, जेवढं सांगतो तेवढंच लिहायचं. ओके, राईट डाऊन दिस लास्ट सेंटेन्स, ओनली लास्ट सेंटेन्स. एफ सी ई इज अ कॉमन नॉर्मल ॲट द पॉईंट ऑफ कॉन्टॅक्ट. कॉमन नॉर्मल म्हणजे त्या दोन्ही इन्व्हॉल्यूटला नॉर्मल ॲट द पॉईंट ऑफ कॉन्टॅक्ट सी. दॅट पासेस टू द पिच पॉईंट पी. व्हॉट इज दिस? This is the law of gearing. Law of gearing काय सांगतो? Common normal at the point of contact must pass through the pitch point in order to transmit constant angular velocity ratio. And we have just proved that in case of involute gears, common normal FCE at the point of contact C passes through the pitch point P. That means involute profiles satisfy the law of gearing. FCE is a common normal at the point of contact. Abhishek Raut. गेला का अभिषेक राऊत? ज्यांचा आवाज येणार नाही दोज विल बी मार्क ॲज ॲबसेंट. मी नाव लिहून घेतो. ओके, अभिषेक राऊत इज नॉट रिस्पॉन्डिंग. अक्षय विधाते. लिहिलं का ते? काय लिहिलं सांग बरं. एवढा वेळ कशाला लागतो? काय लिहितोय सांग. काय लिहिणार आहे सांग मला याच्यातलं. तुला स्लाइड दिसतंय का समोर? त्यातलं कोणतं सेंटेन्स लिहायचं सांगितलं मी? अरे दादा, सगळ्यात लास्ट सेंटेन्स लिहून घे. एफ सी ई इज अ कॉमन नॉर्मल ॲट द पॉईंट ऑफ कॉन्टॅक्ट दॅट पासेस टू द पिच पॉईंट पी. ठीक आहे, माईक ऑफ कर. हे बघा, इफ यू आर नॉट इंटरेस्टेड. ठीक आहे, नाव व्हॉट वी विल डू, आपण एक काम करू. आता तुम्ही एक काम करायचं, मी ज्याचं नाव घेईन त्याने व्हिडिओ ऑन करायचा आणि घरच्यांकडे द्यायचा. ओके, त्याच्याशिवाय तुम्ही जागेवर येणार नाही. किरण.
yes,
तुझा कॅमेरा ऑन कर आणि तुझी वही मला दाखव, तू काय लिहिलंय. नाही नाही थोडस ऍडजस्ट कर ना कॅमेरा, दूर घे दूर घे, दिसत नाही. हां ठीक आहे, ओके ओके ठीक आहे, ऑफ कर. ऋषिकेश डोंगरे, काय लिहिलंय सांग लास्ट लाईन. हे काय आहे? दिस इज द लॉ ऑफ गिअरिंग. बरोबर, लॉ ऑफ गिअरिंग काय आहे मी म्हणतो म्हणून नाही, वाचलंय ना लॉ ऑफ गिअरिंग. ठीक आहे चलो नेक्स्ट. वेन गियर वन इज रोटेटेड इन क्लॉकवाइज डिरेक्शन, पॉइंट सी विल पुश इनवोल्यूट टू अलॉन्ग द लाईन ई एफ. आता हा गियर असा रोटेट केला इन क्लॉकवाइज डिरेक्शन, इफ यू रोटेट गियर वन इन क्लॉकवाइज डिरेक्शन व्हाट इट विल डू, इट विल पुश दिस इनवोल्यूट ऑन गियर टू. हा जो गियर टूचा प्रोफाईल आहे, दिस पॉइंट सी विल पुश दिस अलॉन्ग द कॉमन टँजेंट अलॉन्ग दिस लाईन. ओके, म्हणजे काय, पॉइंट सी जसा जसा हा गिअर रोटेट होणार, दिस गिअर विल ऑल्सो रोटेट, आणि हे टी तिकडे जाणार, हा टी तिकडे जाणार. सो दिस पेअर ऑफ टीथ विल रिमेन इन कॉन्टॅक्ट ॲट पॉइंट सी अँड दिस पॉइंट सी विल मूव अलॉन्ग दी कॉमन टँजेंट. हे थोडं व्हिज्युअलाइज करायचा प्रयत्न करा. आय विल शो द ॲनिमेटेड इमेज ॲट द एंड ऑफ दिस लेक्चर. इफ यू रोटेट द गिअर वन, पॉइंट ऑफ कॉन्टॅक्ट सी विल मूव अलॉन्ग दी कॉमन नॉर्मल ऑलवेज. ओके, म्हणजेच काय, पाथ ऑफ कॉन्टॅक्ट इज ऑलवेज अलॉन्ग दी कॉमन टँजेंट टू टू बेस सर्कल्स. म्हणजे पाथ ऑफ कॉन्टॅक्ट लाईज अलॉन्ग दिस कॉमन टँजेंट एफ सी ई. सो दिस लाईन एफ सी ई विच इज कॉमन टँजेंट टू टू बेस सर्कल्स विच इज पासिंग थ्रू द पिच पॉइंट पी अँड अलॉन्ग दिस लाईन पॉइंट ऑफ कॉन्टॅक्ट ऑलवेज लाईज. सो दिस लाईन इज कॉल्ड एज लाईन ऑफ ॲक्शन. बिकॉज ऑल दी फोर्सेस आर ट्रान्समिटेड फ्रॉम गिअर वन टू द गिअर टू अलॉन्ग दिस लाईन. So this is called as line of action. Okay, फक्त खालच लिहून घ्या, लाईन एफ सी ई इज कॉल्ड ॲज लाईन ऑफ ॲक्शन. आणि तिला लाईन ऑफ ॲक्शन का म्हणायचं, बिकॉज इट इज द पाथ ऑफ कॉन्टॅक्ट बिटवीन ए पेअर ऑफ टीथ, पॉइंट्स ऑफ कॉन्टॅक्ट, पॉइंट ऑफ कॉन्टॅक्ट बिटवीन ए पेअर ऑफ टीथ will always move along this line. So this line is called as line of action. Okay, now next. At this stage, let us define the pressure angle. Pressure angle define karuya. Now for that, you need to draw a common tangent to two pitch circles at point P. Violet color ची line draw karayachi. Vertical line which is common tangent to two pitch circles at point P. Okay, now mark this angle phi, angle between common tangent to two pitch circles and the common tangent to two base circles is called as pressure angle. ठीक है, प्रेशर एंगल इज इंडिकेटेड बाय 5, सो शो दिस प्रेशर एंगल इन योर डायग्राम. एंगल बिटवीन कॉमन टेंजेंट टू टू पिच सर्कल्स एंड द लाइन ऑफ एक्शन एफ सी ई इज कॉल्ड एज प्रेशर एंगल 5. And in case of involute gears, this pressure angle remains constant always. So you can note down this pressure angle is constant in case of involute gears. Ata he kuni sangu shakta ka? Why pressure angle will remain constant? Because line of action is passing through pitch point. Pitch point always lies on the center line and its position is always fixed. So line of action ची position पण fix झाली. And this TT, common tangent to two pitch circles, is also passing through pitch point. And position of pitch point P is fixed. And this line is always tangent to two pitch circles. And या दोन pitch circles चा point of contact इतका change होणार नाही. It is always point P. सो मग टी ची पोझिशन चेंज होत नाही, लाईन ऑफ ॲक्शनची पोझिशन चेंज होत नाही, दॅट मीन्स व्हॅल्यू ऑफ प्रेशर अँगल विल नेव्हर चेंज इन केस ऑफ इन्व्हॉल्व्ड गिअर्स. ओके, सो प्रेशर अँगल रिमेन्स कॉन्स्टंट, दिस इज द रिझन. नाउ इफ यू डू लिटल बिट ऑफ ज्योमेट्री, angle F B P is also angle phi. Kasa? This is angle phi. Okay, this is angle phi. And this is 90 degrees. Angle at P, B P F, kiti zala? 90 minus phi. Angle at F is 90. म्हणजे अँगल एट बी विल बी 5. सो शो दॅट अँगल. अँगल ई ए पी इज ऑल्सो 5 अँड अँगल एफ बी पी इज ऑल्सो अँगल 5. प्रेशर अँगल, शो द अँगल 5. ओके, अँगल ई ए पी दाखवा 5, हे लिहू नका सेपरेट, डायग्राममध्ये दाखवायचं आहे. शो द अँगल 5 ॲट ए अँड बी. नाउ वी गेट दिस रिलेशन, ए ई इज इक्वल्स टू ए पी कॉस ऑफ 5. हे कुठनं मिळालं? फ्रॉम ट्रायंगल ए ई पी. दिस इज ए राईट अँगल ट्रायंगल, करेक्ट? At E is 90 degrees, so triangle AEP is a right angle triangle at E. Cos of phi is equals to adjacent side AE divided by hypotenuse AP. So AE is equals to AP cos of phi. Lunga, AE is equals to AP cos of phi. Please write. Similarly, from triangle BFP, what we get? Triangle of gear 2, BFP. We get BF is equals to BP cos of phi. You don't leave them, guys. AE and BF. AE is equals to AP cos of phi and BF equals to BP cos of phi. The next, if you solve these two equations, or before that, draw this conclusion. Hey, kaisa hala? What is AE for gear 1? AE kya hai? Radius of base circle. Barobar? This is radius of base circle. So base circle radius is equals to, and what is AP? So I will write down, base circle radius is equals to, what is AP? For gear 1, AP काय आहे? Pitch circle radius. Correct? So, base circle radius equals to cos of phi times the pitch circle radius. Right? Cos of phi times the pitch circle radius. Or, base circle diameter is equals to cos of phi times the pitch circle diameter. So, हे शेवटचं sentence लिहून घ्या. Base circle diameter is always cos of phi times the pitch circle diameter. Base circle diameter is always cos of phi times the pitch circle diameter. फक्त हे दोन sentence लिहून घ्यायचे. Equations and this last relation, base circle diameter equals to cos of phi times the pitch circle diameter. So we have these two relations, AE equals to AP cos of phi and BF equals to BP cos of phi. Now solving, simplify karayche, cos of phi equals to kay jala mang AE upon AP. Ikadna cos of phi kay jala BF upon BP. Now don't write this, okay? Cos of phi jala. Now what we will do, we will equate these two equations because both are for cos of phi. We don't equate kela nantar what we get? This AE upon AP is equals to BF upon BP. Okay? Kai lihayche nahi, just listen. AE upon AP becomes equals to BF upon BP. Now let us go back to रिअरेंज केलं मी काय केलं जस्ट आय हॅव रिअरेंज दिस हे बी पी इकडे घेतला आणि हा ए ई खाली घेतला सो व्हॉट वी गेट बी पी अपॉन ए पी इज इक्वल्स टू बी एफ अपॉन ए ई नाउ रिकॉल द इक्वेशन ऑफ वेलोसिटी रेशो वेलोसिटी रेशो डिवाइड्स द सेंटर लाइन और पॉइंट पी डिवाइड द सेंटर लाइन इन द इनवर्स रेशो ऑफ velocities of gears. Velocity ratio equals to काय होता आपला BP upon AP. This BP upon AP. We have defined this in second, third lecture. Okay. Velocity ratio equals to BP upon AP. पण BP upon AP ची आता value काय झालेली आहे? Velocity ratio is BP upon AP, but BP upon AP is BF upon AE. So we substitute this here. So velocity ratio is equals to BP upon AP, which is equals to BF upon AE. Now what about this? BF काय आहे? Base circle radius of gear 2. And what is AE? Base circle radius of gear 1. मग हे बेस सर्कलचे रेडियस चेंज होतील का नो बोथ दिस व्हॅल्यूज आर कॉन्स्टंट सो द सेकंड मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टंट कंक्लुजन फॉर इनवोल्यूट गिअर टिथ्स वेलॉसिटी रेशो इज ऑलवेज कॉन्स्टंट और इनवोल्यूट गिअर टिथ्स ट्रान्समिट्स युनिफॉर्म अँग्युलर वेलॉसिटी रेशो Correct. If somebody asks you the proof, you have to derive this equation. It's very simple. The next, okay, velocity ratio is constant. Now, if you try to change the center distance between these two gears, AB is the center distance. आपण जर हा गिअर इकडे सरकवला टुवर्ड्स राईट इट विल इन्क्रीज द सेंटर डिस्टन्स बरोबर ए बीची व्हॅल्यू इन्क्रीज होणार सो इट विल इन्क्रीज द सेंटर डिस्टन्स पण बी एफची व्हॅल्यू चेंज होईल का और वेदर ए ई विल चेंज नो वी आर जस्ट चेंजिंग द सेंटर डिस्टन्स वी आर नॉट चेंजिंग द रेडियस ऑफ बेस सर्कल्स म्हणजे काय Even if we change the center distance within limits, velocity ratio is not affected. So third important conclusion for involute gear tooth is that velocity ratio is not altered by change in center distance. Okay. So आपण दोन गोष्टी प्रूव केल्या. In case of involute gears, velocity ratio is always constant and velocity ratio is not affected by the change in center distance. But change in center distance may affect the pressure angle phi, and this is not desirable. Okay, change in center distance may affect the pressure angle. Of course, it is not changing the velocity ratio, but it affects the pressure angle. हे दोन सेंटेंस लिहून ठेवा. Velocity ratio is not affected by the change in center distance, but it may affect the pressure angle. And velocity ratio is always constant in case of involute gears. Okay. So next is hala we are studying involute gear tooth action. Involute gear tooth madhe gears kase mesh hotat, kinematics of involute gear. Now beginning of engagement. Now one thing we know for sure, that point of contact C always lies on the pressure line FCE. Okay, we have seen this point of contact C always lie on this pressure line. Pressure line is always tangent to the two base circles. Pressure line is always passing through the pinch point P. Okay, pressure line is called as line of action. Now beginning of engagement. Now where does a pair of teeth comes in contact with each other? म्हणजे दोन टीथ मध्ये वेअर द कॉन्टॅक्ट इज इनिशिएटेड. टीथ ऑन गिअर वन अँड टीथ ऑन गिअर टू यांचा कॉन्टॅक्ट कुठं होतो? सो एंगेजमेंट बिटवीन अ पेअर ऑफ टीथ बिगिन्स वेअर अडेंडम सर्कल ऑफ ड्रिव्हन गिअर कट्स द प्रेशर लाईन. कॉन्टॅक्ट कुठं सुरू होतो? लिसन केअरफुली. Contact begins where the addendum circle of driven gear cuts the pressure line. Now let us suppose that gear 1 is the driving gear and gear 2 is the driven gear. मग आपल्याला beginning of engagement दाखवायचे आहे. So we need to draw the addendum circle of gear 2. Now draw this circle. Draw the circle concentric to pitch circle 2 passing through point of contact C. Draw one circle concentric to pitch circle 2 passing through point C. And tell a now that konta circle ahe? Addendum circle of gear 2. Now engagement between a pair of teeth will begin where this addendum circle cuts the pressure line. Ya addendum circle ni pressure line la kuta cut kelela ahe? Point C la. So a pair of teeth comes in contact at point C. Now end of engagement ulta karayche. Engagement between a pair of teeth will end, or a pair of teeth will go off the contact where the addendum circle of driving gear cuts the pressure line. Okay, ata don teeth contact madhe kuta ale? Point C la. Point of contact will travel towards F along this line. हे दोन टीथ ऑफ कॉन्टॅक्ट तोपर्यंत कॉन्टॅक्ट मध्ये राहणार. कॉन्टॅक्ट कुठं ब्रेक होणार? कॉन्टॅक्ट विल ब्रेक वेअर द अडेंडम सर्कल ऑफ ड्रायव्हिंग गिअर कट्स द प्रेशर लाईन. विच इज द ड्रायव्हिंग गिअर? गिअर वन इज द ड्रायव्हिंग गिअर. सो लेट अस फाइंड आउट द end of engagement. For that, we need to draw addendum circle of driving gear. So draw this addendum circle. A circle concentric to pitch circle 1. This is addendum circle 1 or addendum circle of gear 1 or addendum circle of driving gear. Now this addendum circle cuts the pressure line at point D. The point now they are where the addendum circle of gear 2 cuts the pressure line. Name that point as point D. Point D la kai honar mag? Point D la contact is ceased. That is the end of engagement. A pair of teeth. Suppose gear 1 varcha teeth number 1, gear 2 varcha teeth number 2. They will come in contact with each other at point C, and this point of contact will travel from C to D, and when this pair reaches at point D, they will break the contact. So point C is called as the point of beginning of engagement, and point D is called as point of end of engagement. Okay? So you remember this. Engagement begins where addendum circle of driven gear cuts the pressure line, and engagement ends where the addendum circle of driving gear cuts the pressure line. Now path of contact. Contact kuta initiate zala point C la. Contact kuta break zala point D la. So from C to D, a pair of teeth was in contact with each other. So CD is called as path of contact. Okay. Locus of point of contact from beginning of engagement to the end of engagement. Eka lihu naka, so pa hai lakshya thevay. Okay. Contact kuta start zala point C la, contact kuta break zala point D la. So point of contact between a pair of teeth has traveled the distance CD. So CD is called as path of contact. Okay, mujhe ya path varti a pair of teeth was in contact with each other. Now next is path of approach. Path of contact is divided into two parts, path of approach and path of recess. And what is path of approach? Try to understand. Now, the contact teeth 1 and teeth 2 contact mode kuta ali point C la. So from this to the pitch point, this distance is called as path of approach. Mujhe point of contact tayar zala C la, and point of contact is moving from C to P. That means point of contact is approaching point P. Tumhi kuthe uba rahayche P la, and bagayche point of contact tumcha kade yetoy from C to P. So CP is called as path of approach. Well, you are standing at point P, and what you will observe? You will observe that point C is coming towards you. It is approaching U. So CP is called as path of approach. So you can define the path of approach as locus of point of contact from beginning of engagement to the pitch point. Okay, from beginning of engagement to the pitch point, CP is the path of approach. Now next is path of recess. तर तुम्ही पी लाच उभे आहात, पॉइंट ऑफ कॉन्टॅक्ट आला तुमच्याकडे फ्रॉम सी टू पी, देन इट विल लीव यू अँड इट विल ट्रॅव्हल टू वर्ड्स पॉइंट डी. सो पी डी, पी डी इज द पाथ ऑफ रिसेस. सो पोर्शन ऑफ पाथ ऑफ कॉन्टॅक्ट फ्रॉम द पिच पॉइंट टू द एंड ऑफ एंगेजमेंट इज कॉल्ड ॲज पाथ ऑफ रिसेस. Okay. So we have divided path of contact CD into two parts, path of approach and path of recess. CD is the path of contact, which is equals to path of approach CP plus path of recess PD. Okay. So that's all for today. Hope all of you have drawn this diagram